All right. Hi, everyone. I'm running Call of Cthulhu, Cold Harvest. If you've never played a role-playing game before, essentially what you do is you play a character, and multiple people play characters, and then one person will run the story, and they set out an exposition and set up a scene, and the rest of the players are going to tell the keeper, which is what the storyteller is called, what they want to do, and they make dice rolls to determine if they can do certain things or not, and they progress the story. The particular scenario I'm running now is called Cold Harvest. It's set in the 1930s during Stalinist Soviet Union, and the players are members of the NKVD, which is like a secret police force, and they put people in the labor camps, that kind of stuff. So I'll go around and introduce the characters real quick. Jack, you want to go first?
All right. I'm Alexander Borisovich Biore, NKVD agent, of course, age of 35. I'm essentially an engineer who works for the NKVD because out of a sense of loyalty and to help his father.
Okay. Whoever's next can go.
I can go. I'll be playing Nikita Pavlovich Gukov. Essentially, I fought in the revolution at the age of 15, and my sister became a paraplegic, and so I had to take care of her. And that's part of the reason that I am in the secret police, so I can provide for my sister.
And I am Mikhail Andreevich Akhmarov. I'm just a NKVD agent who gets stuff done, even though he might ask some questions on the way. And he doesn't really care too much about his past. So we'll keep that till later.
All right, and we'll have one more player coming in later. He's just going to be a little late right now, but he will, he'll just kind of slide right in without you guys knowing. All right, so the investigators all find themselves in the city of Kubishev, and they're called in to, what's his name? The captain of NKVD calls them in to give them a new mission. He's got a tight-pressed uniform, his boots are clean and polished, and he's sitting there tapping his fingers on the desk while the other agents take their seats, kind of glowering at them as they pass by. And then he hands them out a, without really saying anything, he's going to hand them out a sheet of paper and says, here is your mission. Provided by Galina Petrona Smolskaya, has been entered into fact as the proof of sabotage by Pyotr and his family against Sovkus.
It's pronounced Pyotr.
Sovkos, Krasivyi, October 3. It has been decided under NKVD order number 00447. The Amarov family consists of the following members. They're listed there. Are to be deported via rail to labor camp Vorkuta for a time no less than 1 year, no more than 3 years. They've been convicted of the following crimes: sabotage of state-owned equipment and treason under the state. Officers of the NKVD, accompanied by members of the militia, are ordered to proceed to October 3 and detain the Abramovs, then transport them to the railway line on pickup on 18th of October 1937. All right. So, yes, do you have any questions?
Mikhail will have 7 or 8 questions. He'll begin by hearing the vast accusations of treason and stolen equipment, and I'd like to know if there's any farther information you give us regarding what they might have taken or what they might have done.
Yeah, it was sabotaged equipment.
Oh.
And I have no further information. However, I'm to remind you that if you see any other anti-Soviet behavior, that you are to immediately correct it and provide more names for us. Anything else?
No, sounds good.
All right, one more thing. Comrade Beria, who's expected to be the appointed head of the NKVD soon, is touring the central Sovksy, and he will be there in 5 days. This should be settled before he arrives. Is that clear?
Da.
Da.
Okay. He directs you to leave, and you guys will have a truck for this. The truck is a Gaz AA. It's like a Ford style pickup truck with a covered back to it. It's just a Soviet looking truck. What does it have on it? It's going to have a full tank of gas. It also has 3 extra fuel cans with it. And it's got a radio stored inside of it, as well as first aid kit and rope. The mechanic gestures towards the truck for you guys to take and go.
I suppose I'll drive, unless anyone has a problem with that.
shotgun.
I do not trust a mechanic, so can I look over the truck before we leave?
Yeah, can we get a mechanical repair roll for me?
Yeah. I'm going to pretend like I know what I'm doing, but I know very little about automobiles. I'll just look over it and then kind of sternly look at the mechanic and shake my head in disgust and then climb to the back seat.
Did you fail the roll?
Yeah, I rolled an 81, but I only had a 10, so it wouldn't have went well either way.
You're like, he looks very good. Yeah, so as you guys leave, it's about an 8-hour drive out to the village, but as you guys leave, the roads are very, very nice up around the city, but the farther out you get, the worse and worse the roads get. Until you arrive at another Sovkaz, Leninsky 2, about 90 kilometers away from the city. If you guys want, you can fuel up here. You have enough fuel otherwise. However, as you guys are looking around, like this is a very little busy village. Like everyone's like doing something. They look kind of afraid of you for a good reason, but they should have nothing to worry about. It's like a normal functioning village. The harvest is good. There's a famine the year before, so it's very good to see that there's plenty of grain going around. But other than that, everyone seems to be very hardworking.
Can I roll a spot hidden check to see if someone's like hiding any anti-Soviet behavior, if everything looks so normal?
That would be a psychology check.
Psychology? All right.
Yeah.
Okay, I rolled a 20 and my percentage is 10, so I do not pass the psychology check. Everything looks great to me. Look at all these patriotic Soviets.
It's honestly just a busy place full of unhappy people.
I'll order my chauffeur to pull over.
I suppose I'm going to ask you why do you think we need to pull over? Do you see any anti-Soviet activity going on?
It is good for these people to know that we are always watching them. It will keep them from trying anything or plotting anything.
How close are we to our destination, real fast?
Let me double check that. Like, so you're like 5 hours away still. Like, you're like, this is like the first one you hit. You're not too far out.
Like, percentage wise, like how far in our
trip? It's been our trip. It's 3 out of 5 hours so far you've traveled.
Okay,
we could pull over and get gas. And while we are getting gas, you can prove what you are trying to prove.
And while you do that, I'll go in and get some Funyuns. Everybody likes Funyuns.
Funyuns were invented in 1938, so they don't exist yet.
No Funyuns. Unhappy-yuns. All work-yuns.
Stalin-yuns.
I think in Russia they just eat raw onion.
I'll get
some raw onions.
Put some mayonnaise on it and some vinegar. That makes it Russian.
Onion vodka. While they're tending to the convenience store, I just like to walk toward the crowd of people looking very intimidating.
None of them are paying attention to you. They're all busy.
I'm following you. What was your character's name?
Mikhail.
All right, I'd follow Mikhail.
I would like to... what is the scene like? Is there any... Are the buildings just brick, or are there... Is there any...
They're little wood shacks. I mean, it's nothing too high quality. It's basically a labor camp.
Can I pick up a piece of wood and strike it against the side of one of these buildings to make sure they're aware of my presence?
Yeah, sure.
All right.
As you do that, everyone kind of just looks pissed that you're just kind of standing there smacking a building with a stick. And then they all kind of stop and look at you.
That's your cue, man.
Yeah. Can I roll psychology, look around and just gauge if I see any of them? I know the majority of them are like, what the crap is this guy doing? But if I can see anyone who looks a little bit suspicious. That's a fail.
Yeah, well, from what you know, though, it is kind of suspicious that they're not working right now, you know?
I call out, Mikhail, gas is done? Stop interrupting these happy Russian workers' work.
There's a reason why these people must live in the cold with barely enough clothing. I hope that their children suckle the barren nipples of their mother late at night.
They do.
Yes. And I will turn back and head to my vehicle.
Yeah, everyone's kind of confused while you're just kind of smacking their buildings and yelling about nipples, but they all get back to work and pretty quick.
Since I'm like standing like behind him and just to the left, I would like sort of like nod as if to emphasize the point and then follow him back to the truck.
Wait.
I give it an emphasizing nod.
Can I make a spot in check to see if any of them are smiling?
Yeah, go ahead.
What's my spot hidden? Damn it. 55 out of 50. Never mind.
None of them are smiling. They're all very unhappy.
Ah, like good Soviet worker.
Can I roll an intimidate check for my nod? You don't have to let. I'm sorry. Okay. 93 out of 55. Nope.
You shake your head no.
So...
I shake my head like this instead.
You guys board back into the truck, and you guys can continue?
Ah.
All right, so you guys start driving down the road, and the farther you get out of this, quick thing for you guys. There's something called pushing a roll. So if you roll below and you're not happy with that roll,
I don't do it because I'm.
You say, "I'd like to push the roll," which means you re-roll. And if you succeed, you succeed. And if you fail, there's usually some kind of like horrible things. Like if you're trying to like dodge out of the way of a truck, and you fail the roll, and you want to try it again, you fail that too, you would trip and get your legs broken, something like that. You know, it'd be something pretty horrible. But yeah, you guys continue down the road.
Double your chances of succeeding, but double the punishment if you fail.
Yeah. And one other thing for you, Adam, if you roll half of, like, so if you need a 20 to succeed on something and you roll a 10, that's a hard success, which means maybe there's a little extra to it. And if you roll a fifth of your score, it's an extreme success, so there's like another extra thing. If you roll a 1, that's a crit. Whereas if you roll 100, that's a crit fail. Or if your gun has a malfunction on like a 99, if you roll 99 or roll 100, there'd be some kind of malfunction.
Okay. If you're bad at the stat, the case will be 95 to 100.
Yeah. So you guys continue driving, but as you get farther away from this village, the roads progressively become worse and worse, and the weather becomes worse and worse, just cold and gross and muddy. So Jack, can you make a drive auto roll for me?
Got it. 25 out of 50, I'm good.
Yeah, you're good. So the road is icy and muddy, but you managed to keep on track like a good Soviet worker.
Russian weather does not bother Russian driver.
Yeah. So you guys arrive around the village at 6 p.m. as the night is falling and the rain is now turning to snow. As you come around the bend, your headlights illuminate a tractor on its side in front of the barn. And the barn doors are wide open, and livestock are freely wandering in and out of it. And there's a couple other small buildings hidden in the darkness. And as you guys step out, you get the smell of rotting vegetables in the air.
All these Soviet cattle are getting loose.
Yeah.
It is not our job to fix it. It is the fault of the drunk farmer. We have our own mission.
I agree. And so it's snowing. We smell rotting vegetables. Have we stopped? We're still driving.
Yeah, you guys have stopped. Okay. There is one building that's being illuminated, but everything else is dark.
It seems to me like the workers here are not properly performing their duty. We should find them.
It's nighttime and snowing. Perfect time for rock farming.
It's true.
Is this farm, is this a work camp or is this a private farm?
This is where you need to be. This is the
people that we said were being bad.
Yes.
You know, the cattle belong to them.
Yeah.
I will walk
over there. They belong to Stalin, but...
Oh, they belong to Stalin.
It's true.
Everything belongs to Stalin.
Stalin is letting them take care of his cattle.
We must rescue Stalin's cows.
This is now Cow Quest.
Oh my god. Yeah, as you guys go to try to herd the cows, the one house that's being lit up, the door swings open and light shines out of it. And there's a large man doorway with a thick, thick beard.
In the name of Stalin, put your hands where we can see them.
The man puts his hands up and he says, "Oh, my name is Gepon."
We did not ask for your name.
I am chief runner of village. Or the village production supervisor.
What are like the three names we're looking for?
You're looking for the Abramov family.
How's the what?
Abramov family.
Abramov?
Yes.
All right. So I would sort of rest my hand on the TT-30 auto pistol that I carry. I would sort of like leave my hand just kind of like lazily near my gun and approach him and demand to know the whereabouts of the Abernov family.
I have lists of villagers. I can give them to you.
How is it that you can control a village if you cannot even control cows?
I have been trying my best, but it's very hard. How did you hear of the murder this morning?
Murder.
And he hands you the list. Excuse me. No, he's going to hand you the list. And he's going to say, hold on, it takes it back. The name Galena, if one of you guys wants to screenshot this real quick.
Is that the same Pyotr Mikhailovich Abramov?
The Abramovs, those first three names are the ones that you were looking for. Galena, down a little lower, she's the one who was, he crossed the name of. Does one of you guys have the screenshot of?
Did any of you guys screenshot it, or?
I did.
YouTube.
It should. What?
Awesome.
Oh, it's a hall of mirrors.
Sorry, yeah,
I should have screenshots on the Facebook group.
Okay. So he hands you that list. Do you have any other questions for me?
Yes, where in your village are the... Wait, hold on. What murder? Tell us about this murder.
Oh, Galina Petrovna Smolskaya was found dead this morning at the edge of a pond, north of it. She probably got drunk and just drowned. But her husband, Vasily Smolsky, thinks she was murdered by the Abramovs or one of her friends.
Do you still have Vati?
Her body's in the Smolskaya residence.
Oh my god, all these Russian people.
It's all awful. Right.
And have the Abramovs left?
No, they're still here.
Okay, well, I say we don't split the party and we go find the Abramovs, but...
It's true. We would follow our duty, yes. And then do the murder.
Before we go, I am very versed in crime law, and I'm wondering if letting cattle wander throughout the city, if that would be considered treasonous in any way.
No, it's kind of like just their cattle; they can do what they want. If they want to, like, you know, let them sleep with them, that's perfectly fine. There's nothing wrong with it. It's just when it comes down to brass tacks and it's time to account for all the cattle, if they're missing cattle, that's on them.
Do you think if they want to sleep with them?
Like, just, like, cuddle up next to a cow.
Oh, okay.
A big spoon.
Did you say that there was a tractor that was turned over?
Yeah, there is.
I would ask, what is it with the tractor? Have you been drinking vodka?
No. The tractor broke down. It's been a rough year. Tractor broke down, the horses are sick, and the weather hasn't been very cooperative with the growing, so
Do you have any tools with which I could use to fix Stalin's tractor?
You do have some tools in the truck.
I am compelled to fix this tractor.
Yeah, and just let you know, it is dark out though right now. Very dark.
I'm not afraid.
What time is it?
Use the car's headlights.
It's like 7 p.m. Like, it's getting late. It's dark. It's cold. Yeah. Each of you make a con roll, actually, for me. A constitution roll. So you just got to roll on your constitution.
Shouldn't we be dressed heavily enough?
You are, but it's snowing. And you guys are all just kind of... It's like negative 10 Celsius right now.
13 out of 65.
You're good.
I got hard to kick.
Okay.
Yeah.
And Adam?
Sorry, what are we doing?
A con roll.
Roll Constitution.
Okay, I got a 19. Let me check that against my...
Yeah, that's enough. That should be enough. Yeah, so you guys get a little shiver, but you're warm enough in your stocky Russian bodies.
Can I make a mechanical repair check on the tractor?
Yeah, do it with a hard success though. They're hard.
I failed miserably.
Yeah, no. You're kind of sitting there like dinging around the tractor, and you go, "Oh, it really is broken."
Like, I do not have requisite tools to fix this. When I really did.
I would speak again to this village leader, King. It is late, and we will not drive back. Where can we stay?
Out of character, you guys don't have to ask where to stay. You just kind of tell them that you're staying there.
And so I walk up to his house. This is a nice house. It will suit us. And I walk into his house.
Yeah. All right. You walk.
Never mind.
Yeah, so you guys walk in the house. And something you guys want to do next.
Far away, like how spread out is this city?
It's very, very tight. I should have a picture. Hold on.
Like, will we still be driving from place to place?
No. Fine. I mean, like, you guys can walk literally everywhere.
I'd like to ask directions to the Abernov residence or whatever.
Give me one sec.
I begin making some light conversation, like, you guys going to watch Russian Super Bowl on Sunday? I hear it's the hammer versus the sickles.
But we all know Stalin wins, so.
Pretty sure it'd be like hockey or curling.
So yeah, you guys are at house 19 right now, and the Abramov residence is number 15.
Hold on, let me take a screenshot of this one too.
Yep. And yeah. Where the truck is on the map right now is where you guys are stopped.
Is 17 the lake?
Yes.
All right. And then the other thing that looks like the lake is a road.
What, that looks like a lake? Yeah, it's the road.
Okay.
So you said we're at 19 and they're at 15?
I won't tell you what everything is, but like...
No, that's fine. But we're at 19 is what you said, right?
Yeah, that's where the house is that you're staying at right now.
All right, and he was saying up the Abramovs live at 15?
Yep.
All right.
If you are here because they are anti-Soviet, they're not. We've all been struggling, but it's not their fault.
Murder is pretty anti-Soviet.
Unless it is. But
they weren't murdered. Oh, they were... Yeah, they were supposedly murdered, Galina.
The removal of a worker. Reason...
Oh, go ahead.
The removal of a worker is anti-Soviet, so we will deal with this as well.
The only reason we're freezing our asses off out here is because they're anti-Soviet.
All right. So yeah,
So we all thinking like it's too late to go over there now, which is why we're in this house, or what?
I actually couldn't get out of the cold while he was being around the truck engine.
What time is it?
It's like it's 7 p.m.
Perfect time for a surprise house call.
There's still day left. We still must work. Why'd the mute button? It's not.
Okay.
I'm struggling with this thing right now. I'm being stupid.
So you guys gonna go to bed?
No, we're gonna go to the house.
You're going to the house?
Yeah, the Akamov Manor.
Manor?
Rifles are ready to make examples of these anti-Soviet pigs.
Alright, so yeah, you guys walked over to their house, and it's a small little shack, like 7 meter by 5 meter. It's not very impressive in any way. So yeah, you guys are
having like straight up to the front door and like with the butt of my rifle, like not try and break the door down, just like crack it against it and yell, in the name of it is who is it? Stalin? Is that it?
Yeah, Stalin.
Okay, you guys walk
by, it's a huge statue of Stalin in the middle of the courtyard as you guys walked in.
Oh, good. Okay, that's nice to see. But yeah, in the name of Stalin, open up. Crack, crack, crack.
You wait a little bit. You hear some rustling around inside, and a groggy man approaches the door and says, yes?
Are you Pyotr Abramov?
Yes.
I immediately try and crack him across the head with my rifle. hold on. I'm not trying to play that guy. What do the orders say? Because I'm looking at my character sheet, and he's like a fanatic about this whole Soviet thing.
It's just
I'm trying to arrest this guy. You know, I wouldn't crack him past that. That's a little harsh.
It's supposedly sabotage of state-owned equipment and then treason.
I don't know. Why not? What do you guys think? Is that
the equipment tractor?
Can I?
Gavron did inform you when you came in. Gavron, whatever his name is, did inform you that it was the tractor. They supposedly broke.
The tractor is obviously broken, therefore he must be guilty. By the way,
I will let you know that the person who provided you the facts is the lady who drowned this morning.
Oh, wow. All right. So, yeah, rather than crack him across the head initially just to say hello, I would begin with a friendly, "You're under arrest in name of Stalin. Follow us to truck."
Dan, let me go wake up family first.
I come with you. I want to meet family. Because I'm not letting this guy go in alone.
Das, very nice family. Wife, son, they work hard in fields.
Can I roll psychology? This is going way too well.
Yeah, go ahead.
That is a hard success.
They know that this is coming and they're just going with it.
I would definitely question him and say, "Why is it that you are so willing to come with us?"
I'm under arrest, am I not?
Yes, but what has drawn you to such crimes, and why are you so eager to follow?
I did not commit crimes, but if I resist, I'll be shot.
We have it from high authority that you're guilty of treason, and possibly murder. Bum, bum, bum.
I did not commit such things. Not murder. Murder was only supposedly. It's treason and sabotage.
Yeah. But why not?
I did not. Charges? I did not sabotage Tractor. If you want to hear about Galena, I did not kill her.
I will pull.
But he also has like these sores all over his face.
Sorry, my mom called.
So what did kill this woman? Some sort of creepy Lovecraftian creature?
Shh. And
let's give us some house.
I will pull.
She just butt down me again.
I will pull the other two aside and kind of whisper to them. This man seems to cause us no trouble. Perhaps we should give him throughout the night with his family. We will not drive anyway. And so we can pick him up in the morning.
Did I miss anything important about the murders?
I'm worried that they will try and slip away.
We can sleep in their house. One person will post watch.
Okay, that's what I mean.
Yeah.
All
right. All right. Yeah, you guys are all asleep. How's watch going to work? His wife and son are also up now.
Okay, so we're gonna do this real ways. Each person takes a 1 hour shift and then sleeps for 2 hours while the next person takes the next 1 hour shift.
Does the wife and son also have herpes?
Are you gonna ask?
Like they have herpes?
Has he brought the wife and son out yet?
Yeah, they're up now.
Can I examine them for herpes or whatever?
It's not herpes. Make a medicine check.
Oh, excellent. How about spot hit? Oh, that wouldn't help either. I don't have medicine, so.
Yeah, okay.
Base medicine is 1%, so if you roll and beat a 1%,
yeah.
I was just seeing more if I just see these, you know.
Yeah, no. You see some on him, but you don't see any on the other two. Ekaterina, which is the wife's name, she says, "No, I have none."
Well, now that you're awake, just know you'll be heading to labor camps tomorrow, but sleep tight until then.
3 days.
What? Well, we're leaving with them tomorrow.
No, they're taken to the train station near the village.
Okay.
And then they're going. But you have like 3 days to wait here.
This is last night in your home. Say goodbye and then sleep tight. Pleasant dreams, child.
Yeah, so who's going to sleep first?
We're not called to watch these people sleep.
The watch is more for ourselves and to make sure they don't run away.
Okay, so can everyone make a luck roll for me?
I triple failed it.
Wow.
12 out of 45.
Okay.
What roll?
Luck.
I thought I heard that. Yeah, I don't have that.
You should. It's under your stats.
Oh. Yeah, okay, I've got luck. 35 out of 50.
Okay, yeah. So, Mikhail, while you're sleeping, you have a really, really odd dream. Give me one second to determine the nature of it.
You're about to take sanity damage. Each diet.
So, in the middle of the night, you have like this weird dream. You wake up basically, you stand up and you go and you look at the wall because you see like a drawing on it, and you just kind of stare at it for a little bit, and these figures start forming, and one of it's like a giant like serpentine thing, and it gets larger and larger and larger, and all of a sudden it pops out of the wall, and you jolt awake, and you're standing in front of the wall. Make a sanity check for me.
Normal,
you're muted. Okay, you take a point of sanity damage, but like this, like jostles you, and you're like terrified.
Who is on watch at the time?
Both of you guys make a luck roll, I guess.
25 out of 45.
37 out of 15.
Check your own.
Okay, so I think I would have reacted if I noticed him standing up.
Yeah, you do see him stand up, and Watkins just kind of stand at the wall.
I'm like, Mikhail, where are you going?
He doesn't respond to you as he's sleeping, but when he wakes up from this nightmare,
wakes up,
he does.
Mikhail.
Yeah, and you would see me jump back from the wall and kind of cover myself, and then look back up and see that it's nothing. And I'll reach into my overcoat and I'll pull out a band of prayer beads. And you'll hear me whisper something underneath my breath, and then turn around and finally notice that you're watching me.
Mikhail, something is wrong. What is wrong?
I cannot sleep in such a horrible house. We should have went back to the nice one that I had chosen.
Yes, but we need to make sure these obvious criminals are not escaping.
They will not go anywhere. Are they going to run in the snow and die?
We've seen worse before. Or at least I have.
Yeah. I am so very peacefully sleeping still.
Now go back to sleep. Your shift starts in about an hour 30 minutes.
So you guys, the next morning rolls around, and what's it called? Everything's fine. The sun is shining, and it's a gorgeous day for harvesting plants or crops.
Gorgeous Soviet day for gorgeous Soviet work.
So what are you guys going to do?
Take the quickest path to bringing them to the train station.
is what I would try and do. I would
immediately the train station. So the train station is called a train station, but it's pretty much just like a little rack, like a little like a wooden stand where you step up to the train, like a little ramp to put the grain up on. But it's nothing more than that. I mean, it's not like a train station where you think people go and they go and they're like, hey, it's like Grand Central Station. It's just a little stand. Train station is a pretty generous term.
That makes sense. That's fine. Do we have to drive there?
Yeah, you can.
Does anyone else want to drive, or do you want me to just drive again? I have decent drive.
I have a 20% drive, so let's
not do that. I'm 50, so...
Yeah, you would be the choice driver.
So yeah, you get up in the truck, and you guys all load up with the family. And,
Make sure seatbelts are on. Wouldn't want valuable workers to be dead.
Seatbelts weren't invented yet. You start up the car.
Each other tight. Wouldn't want valuable workers to be dead.
You start up the car and nothing happens.
I get out and attempt repairs.
You go and you put the hood of the car up and you realize like the engine's just been fucked with completely.
Okay, mechanical repair. Let's go.
Okay, yeah, you can go ahead and do that.
69 out of 75.
No, you need an extreme success for this. Damn. Because there are parts missing. Stuff's been pulled out.
Stuff's actually missing? Why didn't you say so?
I'm going to march into the house of that first guy in house 19 and drag him out in his bedclothes.
Well, he's actually... Okay. Yeah, so you go and you pull him out into the street. He's screaming, why are you taking me?
Somebody has taken parts from car.
Do you think it was me?
Yes, no,
but you
are
in charge of workers. You will find person for us.
I don't have anything to start with. I don't know what to do. Like,
find them.
Call everybody out in front of Stalin statue. The eye of Stalin sees all.
Yeah, so he rings his village bell. No, actually, he goes to the Stalin statue, presses a button, and a giant red light goes up and flashes around. It's meant to rally everyone around Stalin.
Holy shit.
Everyone comes running
from that kind of stuff.
No.
So music that's like really loud horns. But like the audio quality is really bad, so it kind of just sounds like the whole time.
Yeah, it's like an early air raid siren. Everyone comes to the village center, and like everyone's just kind of standing around, like what's it called? Like confused as to why these NKVD agents just ran into town and like.
I will start yelling about how we're here on special business directly from, is it the Kremlin? Was the Kremlin there in the 30s? I don't know Russian history.
Yeah, maybe, I don't know. Jack, Russian history. Yes, it was there.
Okay, I'd be screaming about how we're on a mission directly from the Kremlin and someone has interfered with us and has therefore interfered with the Soviet Russia and Stalin himself. And I don't know. It'll be easier. The pain will be the least if you come forward now.
If no one comes forward, we assume village is guilty. And everyone in village is punished.
A man like in like tattoos. Pushes forward Abramov and says, it was him! Pyotr, the guy's house you're in.
Can't have been him. We've had eyes on him all night.
Pyotr says, no, I saw him with my own eye. the tattooed man says, "No, I saw Malaya," as he pushes him again.
I will get
this guy's. Shirt is like.
It says "Bro, like West" on it. Almost,
no, it's like sticky, like, and wet looking.
I will give this man a ration from my own kit to reward him for choosing Stalin over his fellow townspeople and trying to show the others that we will reward those who can give us information.
All right. So as you do that, all the townspeople just start shouting and yelling about how their neighbor so-and-so is a spy, and that everyone's just shouting at this point, you know, like almost like a riot.
So
trying to get rations from you guys.
As a player, I know that something's fishy going on because we're playing Call of Cthulhu and we watch this guy all night, so maybe there's like a shapeshifter or something. What do I roll for my character to like pick up that
something fishy is going on? Or someone's lying.
Or someone's lying with. So what do I roll?
What are you trying to figure out? What are you trying to figure out?
I assume he wants to know if tattoo guy is a liar.
Psychology check. Oh shit! I have 10% psychology. I'm more Logan like a.
Was the doctor?
I'm suspicious as well, and I have 45% psychology. So.
Well, I mean, I've already rolled. I got a 19 out of 10, so I did not succeed.
Don't forget to push a roll too.
No, that's all right. I am unaware.
Jack?
Let me roll. No, I failed as well. I got a 71.
You can push rolls. If you have a 45, you have a 50-50 chance for the most part.
I have a
feeling. Yeah, but you know me.
I have a feeling that I know this guy probably isn't the most reliable since his shirt is looking like it's vomit stained.
But you gave him a ration anyway.
It is the nationalist way.
You turn the people instead of stick, comrade.
You turn the people against each other, and then they can only trust Stalin.
Are they still like screaming and stuff?
Jack, are you gonna push the roll? Sorry.
You know, I've never done this, and I want to see how this turns out if I fuck it up. So, I rolled exactly a 45 out of 45.
Yeah, you can tell that he is definitely lying.
Yeah? And I'm like, comrades, tattooed man is obviously a liar. We knew where Piotr was all night.
We snuggled with him. Yeah, he's just kind of like, no, why are you in league with this man? He killed, what was her name? I can't remember these names, they're awful. He killed Galina. How could you not see?
So would Mikkel like make it clear to the two of us that this guy is like definitely lying?
Unless it says so.
I mean, I just said this, comrades. This guy is obviously lying.
After your accusation, I hear your accusation, I will hand you a stick and tell you what you must do to liars.
Wait, hand me a stick?
No.
What is it, me a stick?
Yes.
And I nod. approach and attempt to strike the back of the liar's legs.
Yeah, you knock on the back of the legs, and he's going to turn around, and he is going to try and punch you.
Shoot him.
Hold on.
No tolerance.
I'm nonchalantly just pulling my gun out.
Are you going to draw your gun?
Yeah, well, I'm not in this fight. I'm kind of like behind him. So I'm like nonchalantly just.
Yeah, he's going to hit you with a punch. Jack, take 2 damage as he punches you in the gut.
Okay.
I'll shoot him when I get the chance.
You have your gun drawn?
I always draw my gun during this, depending on how you're doing combat.
Okay, so you draw your gun, and as you're getting ready to kind of aim it at him, your gun just goes off. Like, your finger wasn't on the trigger. It goes off. Let's see who it hits.
Me, because I'm the luckiest person on the planet.
Nah, it's going to shoot someone.
Whichever townsperson has a pronounceable name is still dead right now.
Oh, I'm just kind of trying to decide who should be shot. I'll just shoot someone nameless. Boris. Well, there's a Boris I have my finger on. No, you're gonna shoot and you're gonna hit a so like kind of one of those no name like townspeople, and you know they're gonna just like all just like fucking just bolt out of there because now they're terrified of you.
Wouldn't they just cower though, knowing where we are and who we are?
Well, no, they're gonna go for their homes.
I'll probably drop my gun as it goes off.
Yep.
We're dropping guns.
Does the fight, is this fight still going on, or does the guy who just threw the punch run?
I don't know, Jack, what do you do?
I'm going to smack him upside the head with a stick.
Yeah, go ahead and roll the hit.
Ah, what am I rolling on?
Brawl.
I'm rolling my brawl. I rolled a 35 out of 45.
Yeah, you're going to, or with like, what are you hitting him with?
The stick I'm holding that I tried to take his legs out with.
I think you handed him your rifle.
I just handed him a random stick.
He handed me a random stick and I tried to hit him with it.
So do a D6. What's your damage bonus?
All right, so damage bonus is 1D8.
Oh, jeez, really?
How big are you?
No, it's D4. Remember, it's D4.
It's a D4.
Yeah.
So a D6 plus a D4.
I still did the same amount of damage. 8 damage.
8 damage? So you're going to smack him with a stick. And they're like right across the chest. And his chest bursts like a liquid out of him. And like his shirt kind of like falls away, and you see like these like cancerous like sores oozing pus.
Oh God, it's Resident Evil.
Bad herpes.
This man was clearly Patrick's lover.
Welcome to the family, son.
Jack, what's your character's name?
Alexander, but you would say Sasha because that's what they do in Russia.
Okay. In Russian trash.
So I would like yell like Sasha, back away from this man. Meanwhile, drawing my own rifle, not firing it, but just kind of like aiming my rifle at this guy.
Yeah, your rifle goes off while you're aiming at him.
Oh, fuck.
No, I assume we would have really good weapons discipline and raise the weapon.
Oh yeah, no.
Instead of finger cross.
No, I mean, it's Soviet Russia. No, are you? You're drawing your gun on him, like
because if he has his gun held like this. Down to up.
No, I mean, but are you aiming?
Hitting a random target is less iffy.
Adam, you're aiming your gun at him?
Yes.
You're aiming your gun at him? Yeah, it's going to go off while you're aiming at him.
Okay.
Roll damage.
Oh, you hit.
Five.
Yeah, so you put a round right through. You put a round right through his chest, and he's now bleeding and sputtering blood.
Okay, so I'm gonna back up and draw my pistol on him, and I'm assuming it's gonna go off.
Make a luck roll.
I didn't get a luck roll.
4 out of 45.
Yeah, Jack. Jack's gun does not go off.
Well, I'd make it go off.
Yeah,
That'll yeah. show him.
That'll show him. Yeah, so you you shoot him right in the chest, and it finishes him off. You just murdered a man in the street.
Welcome to Soviet Russia. He was obviously a monster anyway. Gonna go play basketball against the Looney Tunes.
It's not murder. He attacked the officer.
It's true.
That's right.
He assaulted an officer. I reacted in the traditional way.
Where did our friend in House 19 run away?
I pushed the
well, they all come back out. They all come back out, like, as you realize that he's dead.
Who is this man? I would scream at him.
A woman and a child run forward. They both get dark hair, and they go, "You killed him! Why?"
While brandishing my weapon, I am like, "He attacked a Soviet officer. Please back up, or you will also be shot."
Yet they saw him attack, didn't they?
Hmm?
Yeah, they did. You killed him.
It's just business.
The little girl goes, "Daddy!"
Well, I remorselessly say, he attacked a Soviet officer. These are the consequences.
they stand there sobbing, and Boris Galron, the man who approached you the previous night, steps forward and says, he was always very violent in recent months. I don't know what spurred him to do this.
Some sort of weird magic, I bet.
Whatever is causing this strange cancerous outburst from his stomach.
It's the same kind of cancerous stuff that's on Abramov. Or Pyotr, Peter, whatever his name.
So we definitely need to quarantine Pyotr.
You slept in his house last night.
I mean, I don't... What if he's like violent like this guy?
Yeah, but he couldn't have touched us if we were keeping watch.
I would let him kiss me. No, I say we lock him in his own house and then, like, take the other two to the train station. Or not. Or lock them in a different house.
In their own house, maybe?
Well, no, I think we lock him in his own house and then we lock them... like in House 19 or whatever.
Okay, yeah.
There's clearly some kind of outbreak here. We need to notify military.
Just remind you guys that your guns did go off randomly.
Mine didn't.
That's right.
I'm assuming theirs did.
Very pointedly.
You see, I didn't notice whether or not they actually fired their weapons, so I'm assuming they fired them on purpose.
Yeah.
And somebody just had a really bad shot.
Not me. I hit that guy. All right, we can't take them to the train station or get to the military because our Jeep is broken. Let's search for the parts, I think, so that we can try and fix this car. I ask that our guide or whatever, is there anyone in town who might know how to fix our car?
You actually have the list of people.
I ask where the man I just shot lives, because he is obviously the one who took our car parts in my
car. Okay. He points you over to a house. House 16.
Yeah, okay, I see on the list who has training now. What was the name of the guy we killed?
Hold on. Gapon does. Oh, his name was Andrei Yazarov. He says, "Well, Gapon and Gapon says Andrei and Pyotr started their workday like later and later. It initially started like 8 or 9 months ago. More and more people like kind of stopped feeling like going to work, and so a lot of people stopped during that same time. That's also when Andrei became incredibly violent. Piotr's face also started around the same time that people stopped working.
Would my character be able to piece this together?
If you personally can piece together, yes.
Oh, yeah, okay. That's fine. So something happened, some kind of like fungus or infection that is affecting townspeople, and we got to either escape or figure out what it is. Does that sound about right?
Yeah. Jack, you want to check out the Yezarov's house?
Yes. So that's the next logical step would take.
I'll follow him.
Okay, it's actually across the street from the Abernon's house, and you approach the door.
All right, so I'm going to have my pistol out, but aimed towards the ground because I have good weapon discipline. And then we are going to open this house and search it. Unless it's locked, then we're gonna figure out how to unlock the door and then search it.
Yeah, the house is unlocked.
Okay.
you walk in, like, all the furniture in the house is like smashed and broken. Also, there's some papers sitting on the little girl whose dad you just killed. She is sitting at a table drawing. And the mother is crying in the kitchen. Or kitchen, but it's really just a...
We are here to search your house, woman. Just as a note, in Russian, calling someone woman instead of girl is actually technically an insult, so...
Okay. So yeah, you search. Go ahead and make spot hidden rolls, I guess.
I don't see shit.
Yeah, I'm still pretty shook up about my gun going off, so I don't hear anything.
Well, yeah, so there's a little girl sitting there drawing. She's, like, covered in, like, charcoal from, like, drawing with charcoal. yeah.
I got a 77 over 45 for spot hidden.
So we're all blind.
Larry Curly and Mo, Russia edition.
Yeah, so you guys can check around anything in the house, like looking at particular places?
So the all the furniture is destroyed. Is there anything of note? Like, it's like if a bookcase was destroyed and there's like papers scattered or...
Is it open around? And no, it's two rooms. There's a bedroom and then this room. But as you're looking around, you notice that you look at the picture that the little girl is drawing. It looks like this.
It's spooky. I bet it's spooky. Hey, Leviathan!
Oh my god, some sort of creepy snake thing and a suicide and heads.
Ich dichte picture on the wall.
There's a picture that the little girl's drawing.
Yeah.
But I believe the snake thing would be familiar.
Yeah, the snake thing is familiar. However, the rest of it is not.
Well, that looks like the lake.
Oh, yeah, there's a lake. It's definitely something in the lake.
It's a woman getting her head cut off. That's a man who either melted or had their head cut off and is now in a puddle.
And is that us killing her dad?
Yes.
Cool.
There's no stick in this picture. A weapon of choice.
Haven't you rolled over everything else but smashing someone with a stick? The little girl goes, how would I see in my dreams? To see me in my dreams.
I would definitely take this piece of paper away and give her a new one. It is not good for little girls to draw such scary pictures. Why don't you draw a nice dancing bear?
Maybe riding on some sort of circus ball, I add in.
Maybe draw a hammer and sickle.
So we take the drawing. I assume now, so we didn't find our car parts. They weren't just like sitting around or anything.
Have we searched the bedroom?
No, you have not.
Let us search the bedroom.
Yeah, so Jack.
Keep an eye on the door.
So, Jack, you go to the bedroom. Who's going to keep an eye on the door? All right, okay, Adam?
Yeah, what's up?
You keep an eye on the door, and then Josh, you're gonna like kind of stare at that drawing, like you're kind of almost like frightened by it. Actually, make a sanity roll for me.
He's making a sanity roll.
I am good. I rolled under.
Yes, you still take a point of sanity damage. Because you're like in a sudden realization that like, holy shit, this is what I saw in my dream. So Jack, you go over to the bedroom and kind of peek around there and like the floor. And Maria, the woman, comes in and like she like rubs up on you, if you know what I mean. She says, "Hey, I need something to forget about my husband's death. Maybe we could," and she eyes the bed.
And I say, "You are trying to impede NKVD officer work. Please move to other room."
You should stick on her.
I would hold up my stick. I brandish it. it's just like a branch from the ground.
Impeding the progress of Stalin Russia.
Yeah, she's gonna say, "Oh, you'll want it later, I'm sure." And she kind of wanders off. There's nothing else of like to note in there.
I'm going to move the mattress on the floor.
There's nothing under
it. Flipping it. I'm gonna flip it like that.
Like that. Yeah, there's nothing in there.
Okay. Anything to spot hidden?
Is it a 32 out of 50 ergonomic Casper mattress? Casper mattress. Sponsor our stream.
There is one rolled up in the corner of the room, though. Hasn't been used.
Mattress gate.
Do I see anything with a 32 out of 50 spot hidden?
No. Okay. You do see more and more that there's like all this stuff, like just all this drawings in the windows.
Drawings on the windows.
The walls and charcoal. Oh.
Are they similar?
Yeah, they're all like depicting like a reptilian kind of thing.
So the government.
No, the reptilians are too large to be in the government. It's usually the hybrid reptilian humans that are in control.
That's true.
That's a whole can of worms.
But our glorious leader Stalin was obviously not one, and that is why his ideals were different.
Of course.
Okay, so I'm going to leave the room and report that I found nothing.
Yeah, so...
Disappointing, but there's nothing to be done.
Yeah, so Adam, you said you checked the list to see if there's anyone with like any electrical or mechanical stuff?
Yes, I have his wife knows a lot about mechanical stuff.
Who?
Yeah, his wife has mechanic training. The guy we killed. The woman
in his house. Somebody talking to? Yeah. Anyone else?
And Pavel Zukov has mechanic training.
Don't forget, Sasha has electrical repair and mechanical repair at very high.
They're looking for. He's looking for someone who may have been the one to take apart the truck.
Yeah, so tired of this game. I will approach her and just like start screaming, "Where are our parts? What have you done with our truck
parts? Where are our parts? In your pants."
Who?
The wife of the dead husband.
She says, I did not take them. You guys searched the house pretty thoroughly and didn't find anything.
Then you must know what happened. Come look at our engine. Who's done this? You have mechanic training. I yell, like, smashing the list into her face.
Smash the last table.
The one piece of furniture they have left.
Shoot the bed twice.
Oh, my God. I'm going to try and get her to come with me to look at the truck.
Yeah, so you guys walk out of the house, and... as you look, there's a house where like all the windows have been blacked out completely. Kind of sticks out to you.
I wonder what's going on in there.
Probably some dirty capitalist stuff.
Some dirty capitalist things and stuff.
So wait, first, what happens at the truck?
She just kind of stares at it. She doesn't know what you're trying to prove. She doesn't know anything.
Oh my God, fine. I'm just gonna like leave her next to the truck then. And
are you sure that's a good idea? Take her back to the house and then we'll search the other one.
Fine, yeah.
Or just like leave her next to the truck so she can take more parts.
Well, it doesn't. Alright, I escort her then back to the house and say, grieve with your child. And
Jesus, Adam.
We have no chill right here. Very good. Very good.
Very good. So, yeah. I mentioned there's the house with the blacked out windows.
We are going to search it, and we are going to enter very much in the same way, where we have our weapons with proper handling, and we are going to come through that door.
I'm going to wield a knife from here on out. I think...
I will brandish my stick. Wait, can I use mechanical repair to tie his knife to my stick and make a spear?
No.
What about my own knife?
Technically, this is supposed to be a serious, gritty game.
Yes, and I am making a spear. This is Survival Horror 101.
This isn't Survival Horror. This is just horror.
Okay, so I would approach the door and again knock and yell in the name of Stalin, open up.
Like a door kind of... the door opens up. He says, "Come in, come in, come in." And he like hurries you in the house.
Sensing the urgency, I would quickly go into the house.
I'm going to brandish my stick and enter the house.
He goes, "Are you NKVD?"
Who's asking?
Are you?
It's obvious.
I killed Galina. Please, you have to arrest me.
Explain yourself.
I'm an Upir. A vampire. And I had to feed. I killed her. Normally I feed on cattle, but I saw her. And I couldn't control myself.
Is it daytime outside right now?
Yes.
You want to push him out the door?
Lucia, my wife, she's a concubine. Please, you have to arrest me.
Do I have handcuffs?
Can I roll psychology to figure out if he's...
Wait, do you push him outside first, or do you...
I'm going to roll psychology.
Go ahead.
5 out of 45.
What's your occult knowledge?
Occult. I think I have base occult, which is 5%.
Okay, you don't know a lot of occult stuff, but you know that to be a vampire, you gotta have fangs, and you gotta cast a shadow. He doesn't have fangs, and he doesn't cast a shadow.
So he has one of the two things.
He doesn't have either.
Oh. Okay.
He can't. No, he casts a shadow, and he doesn't have fangs.
All right. So I say, I believe you are lying. Come with me, and then I push him out the door.
You're just seeing what you want to see.
I push him into the daylight.
He screams, and he rides on the ground.
Does anything else happen, or is he just crazy?
His wife, Lucy, says, stop! You're going to kill him!
Roughly pull him back inside.
He screams, and then he falls flat on the ground.
Is he dead?
We killed another one, boys. We're 2 for 2.
Lucia runs out to the house with a knife, and she slashes her wrist and puts it in his mouth.
Holy shit.
And he stands back up, and he sprints back in the house.
Is she bleeding out? No,
she just she got her wrist a little bit.
Okay, is she like, all right,
comrades? This guy is clearly insane.
So what's that guy? And he chewed on the uteruses. Which killer was that? Andre Chikatilo.
I was gonna say Jack the Ripper.
Well, yeah,
he didn't chew on it, but he tore it out. Yeah, Andre Chikatilo. My sociology professor brought up Ted Kaczynski today, and I got more excited than I should have.
Dude, someone brought up Ted Kaczynski in one of my classes today, too. Weird, and it wasn't me. It's usually me, but it was someone else. I went on like this rant about how technology is just like a long-term cultural suicide. And someone was like, you sound like Ted Kaczynski, and I was like, ooh, that's not a good sign.
Eat your cake and have it, too?
No. What? Yeah, well, I mean, he said that.
No, have your cake and eat it, too. Eat your cake and have it, too. Yeah. So these guys are screaming. They run back into the house.
I'm going to demand explanations very loudly and gruffly.
What?
Said I'm going to demand explanations from the two of them. Like, calm, succinct explanation.
I'm a vampire. There's nothing more to it.
What do I have to roll to figure out if his pain was real?
medicine check?
Medicine.
Okay. Stab him in the heart with a wooden stake. If he survives...
Wooden stake doesn't care if he's a vampire. Wooden stake kills anyway.
If he survives, he is lying.
Where is my?
I'd ask if he knew anything about like the gross weirdo.
I had
more like what's been going on in this town that's been like making everyone all morose and not happy to serve the Soviet farms.
Is it capitalism?
Wait, what'd you say again?
Go ahead.
Yeah, I would ask if they knew anything about the guy that was covered in boils that we killed. And, like, what was wrong with him, and what's wrong with everyone in this town.
Nikita, like, kind of, like, he's hyperventilating, and he explains that he doesn't know, but he hasn't noticed it. Being a vampire, I don't go out much. You saw what happened.
There's no such thing as vampires. What are you?
I'm a vampire!
How much knowledge?
Clearly, you were not taking much to remember. Sorry, you can go.
Yeah, how much knowledge do our characters have of vampires?
What's your cult?
60.
Make a cult check.
All right.
Spooky, spooky.
I will push that roll. All right, extreme success and the push.
You know, whatever you can find on Wikipedia about vampires. I don't want to explain it all out.
Is there a mirror anywhere in the house?
Make a luck check.
We could get the car mirror.
I failed the luck.
Jack, you want to go tear the mirror off your Soviet-issued vehicle?
We can't do that. That's un-Soviet.
Take him outside to the car. Okay. Is it... Would vampires in like this context apply that they don't have a reflecting period, or only in mirrors?
They don't have a reflection.
In mirrors. It takes the silver. Okay, yeah. But they would have a reflection in other things that don't have silver?
I don't know. I'll say, yeah, they do. All
right. We'll play. Have I seen a mirror anywhere thus far?
Nah, you failed to look, girl. All
right.
Could we pour like some water into a bucket and make him stare into it?
Is my pocket watch made of silver?
Your pocket watch?
Yes.
Make a luck check.
Uh, 33 out of 45.
Yeah, it is.
Okay. So, what do we know about vampires being touched by silver?
I don't actually know if that's a thing or not.
I don't know if that's a thing.
It's not a thing.
How reflective is it? How well do I keep it shined?
I would say you keep it pretty well shined.
Yeah, okay, it should work like a mirror.
Let's try to use it as a mirror. Does he have a reflection, or at least a vague reflection?
He has a reflection.
Okay, he's not a vampire. He's just crazy.
He just lied.
You're just a crazy
man. Push him back outside. Torture him.
Well, but this does not mean that he did not kill the woman. Well,
that doesn't necessarily.
The woman's body is still over at the house.
Now that we found out he's lying, can I roll psychoanalysis to see what has caused this delusion?
Yeah.
Hard success.
He's just insane. There's nothing else to it.
So did I roll a psychology check on him earlier?
Yeah.
And I determined that he... Did I determine he was lying or not?
Yeah, he was lying.
Okay. So what about the murder? Do I have to roll a new one for that?
No, he'll still insist that he did it, but he's clearly lying about it. Or he's lying. Okay, so
he didn't do the murder either.
No.
And he doesn't know anything about what's happening. You want to just break a window and leave? I mean, he's clearly not being a productive member of society, so we still have to arrest him.
I mean, no one here is a productive member of society.
We don't know that nobody's being productive.
Well, okay. After reviewing the fields, after you guys walked around a little bit, you did notice that the fields were just, like, rotting vegetables everywhere. Like, they just didn't pick them.
So I thought we need to kill this village leader.
To make an example of them.
Is it his job to make sure that work's being done?
I believe we would have to arrest him and instead a new village leader. Probably order one from the Russian.
Order one from the Russian.
Mail order village leader.
We'll have to put in for a new village leader and arrest the current one.
Yeah.
Great, we'll do that as soon as we can get out of the city. All of these houses hide something. We need to check them all. How many houses were there in the town?
It's like 20.
We should split up.
No. That was metagaming, sorry.
These people are weak. They fear us. And we are armed.
Do you guys have a rifle?
No, I've got a pistol.
You guys have all pistols?
My pistol's staying in my holster for a while.
I've got my stick.
I have a large knife.
Okay. What's it called?
Since this guy's a vampire, can we recruit him for the night watch?
No.
Does he have anything sharp that I can tape to my stick?
He's got a kitchen knife.
Can I tape it to my stick?
Yeah.
Okay, I have a spear now. I realize that there's something going on and I need a stronger weapon than a stick. And I don't want to use my pistol because clearly you guys are having malfunctions.
I would never admit to having a malfunction.
That's fair.
It says I have an optional silencer. I'm going to put that onto my pistol.
Sorry.
You should go help the house.
I'm curious about this lake.
Yeah, you guys gonna check it out?
Is the body still at the lake?
No, it's in the house. I told you guys that earlier.
It's in the house.
We need to examine the body to see what kind of wounds there are.
All right, yeah, that's fine with me. Let's head over to the house where the body is, and we can roll some failing checks on it.
Yeah, we can all rotate failing medical checks on it.
You guys need Logan. Everyone takes Logan.
Logan, make a medicine check.
Logan, we need a doctor bad.
CalQuest 2017.
All right, let's take a quick break. Bother Logan for a little bit. And then we can all come back and continue. So I'll say we'll come back at 9.
Okay.
So if you're watching this, just give it 15 minutes. Take a break.
Too bad there was no chair cam because we all switched our cameras off. Chair cam is big hype.
Did you see the Fire Emblem Heroes?
Yeah, it looks like a Dynasty Warriors Fire Emblem.
No, it's like a mini. It's like a mini. It's an iOS Fire Emblem.
Ah.
Like, I thought it was going to be something different. It plays very similar to it. Which, Adam, if you want to go on the App Store or whatever you have and download Fire Emblem Heroes, it's fairly similar to how regular Fire Emblem plays.
Okay.
Except Fire Emblem is a waifu simulator, too.
Really? It's true, though.
It's like, one of the big parts of it is you form relationships between other characters. So, like, as they fight together, they'll like develop relationships and then become closer, and they have powers up them up in battle and stuff.
What's the main gameplay mechanic of Fire Emblem?
It's
turn-based strategy.
Yeah, turn-based strategy.
Mm.
Heavy, heavy story though.
Can you play Bravely Default?
Turn-based. No, it's like a grid combat.
Think like Dungeons and Dragons combat.
I'm just saying, have you played Bravely Default?
I have not.
Yes.
I have. I keep meaning to buy it sometime.
Yes, because I long for the days of the original Final Fantasies.
You're saying Final Fantasy 15 isn't amazing?
It is amazing. It's just not anything like any other Final Fantasies.
Which, by the way, Final Fantasy 15 is fantastic, Adam. I've played it for like all of like 2 hours now. I love it. I'm in love.
No, I've got it too. I got it for Christmas. I haven't played it.
I'm not super far into it. I'm only like 10 hours. But
15.
10 out of like the 150 hours it's clearly going to take. And I think it's pretty good.
I'm ready to get Redbox, which, by the way, is the best way to do anything if you want to try a game.
I own the game.
Suck a dick. If you've never played a game before and you want to try it out, Redbox is the way to go. It's $3 to try it.
We don't have those here.
Jack. Suck my dick.
I should have done that with Dishonored, too.
Like innocent.
Yeah.
I was on it.
I did it from Dishonored. I did it for Dishonored 2. Logan!
Logan. Hello.
Hi. So we have thrown a man who thought he was a vampire into sunlight and watched him writhe. It was pretty enjoyable.
They so far have done nothing to progress the story, except they have killed a man.
I beat a man with my stick because he was not following our orders.
Is okay. He did not follow orders of party, so it was to be expected. Also, why did my camera just get mirrored?
I don't know.
Mine's doing it too. So we run into like a number of medicine checks, and none of us have it.
Well, let me just check my character really quick. Katya, do you have medicine?
Oh, you might want to pick the doctor.
Okay, I'll do that instead then. How you doing?
Hi, how you doing?
No, we don't need medicine.
How you doing?
We're here to prove that they're productive members of society, which they clearly
are
not.
There was an error loading my app. I don't know what that means.
They're clearly not productive members of society.
Oh yeah, Logan, so I was talking about...
They did not leave orders from parties, so they were terminated according to regulation.
I now have a stick with a knife taped to it, so there's that.
Oh, did you make a mechanical
traditional on that check?
All right. Yes. Which type of mechanics? Mechanical repair?
Yeah.
48 out of 75.
You make it very well. Logan, you've played with Adam before. You know Jack. And then this is Josh. I played Pulp Cthulhu with him, which is Call of Cthulhu, but you have a lot more health, and you just kind of, it's Rudy Tooty point and shooty Call of Cthulhu.
Rudy Tooty point and shooty?
This is literally a mechanic for heroic deaths.
Implying we haven't been doing that anyway.
This one's okay because you're literally murdering innocent civilians. But, no, like, it's literally like I ran around and I was shooting cultists like crazy. And then I just took a dynamite and ran into like a Cthulhu spawn's mouth and exploded.
I don't know why it's mirroring my camera.
It's doing the same thing to me. Don't worry about it.
It is pissing me off. Okay, look, but were you in the audiovisual department? Actually, yes. You know the pains of camera work. I completely forgot that you were doing that morning show thing.
Well, you guys are both. So then you guys both did that, didn't you?
Yeah, the reason I noticed is because of that. It's because it was also bothering me.
Mine wasn't mirroring it last time, though, is the weird
also
part.
Because I held up like a Mike and Ike's thing, and it's backwards.
It's frontwards.
It looks
here.
Proper. It looks proper for me.
Oh, yeah.
What side are my posters on?
Is it mirrored for the person who's like, only for yourself?
Yeah, because the Cowman shirt is fine on my end. So
fine on your end, too.
Yeah, I guess it's just mirroring it for us, for how we see our own camera. Okay, that's enough bitching about camera.
All right, so rundown of the story, and this will be good for the broadcast, too. We were live with one viewer, and I think it's me because I have it open.
I don't have it open, so it was not me.
It is me because I have it open.
I read it through for yourself. You'll never know what's happening.
Every once in a while, there'll be like, it'll bump up the two viewers and then immediately disappear because I think someone thinks they're playing a video game. Because I haven't explained it well enough that it's a nerd game where we... Oh, two.
Oh, boy. I bet it's loaded.
We gotta get Holden to jump in on this. He loves jumping into MP streams.
I'll message Holden.
CalQuest 2017.
Cowman 2017. I'm wearing a shirt for his band. He'll have
to
come
this
in.
With this dice rolling out.
Yeah, send a message. Get Holden on here. As if you just go get home.
So are you going to do the last time on Dragon Ball Z thing or not?
You know what?
Where we last left off.
Jack, you give a synopsis of what happened.
Okay. So it's been a shit show. So we drive into town because we believe that somebody is breaking equipment and not being productive. We find out there was a murder. But we continue on with our job, planning on dealing with the murder second. So we spend the night. Fucking Josh, Mikhail, is his character's name, has a nightmare and gets real spooked. The next day, we end up pulling everyone. Our car gets dismantled, kind of. Somebody takes parts from our engine. And we gather everyone in the village around the Stalin statue to figure out who did it. And there was a really slimy tattooed guy who was...
Everyone in town meet around Lenin statue. But we don't have Lenin statue. Entire town is executed because they do not have Lenin statue.
Exactly. Anyway, slimy guy with tattoos claims that it's the guy whose house we slept in who took the parts, the guy who we are arresting. But we had eyes on him all night, so he's clearly a lie. He is being belligerent, so I go to beat him with my beating stick, and he punches me. So we all three of us try to shoot him, but guns have weird properties here. And Mikhail ends up shooting some random person. And then the other
is okay. They witnessed the assault of party officer and did not intervene on their behalf.
And
he's deserving of.
Both other characters managed to shoot the guy. I also hit him again with the stick after he punched me. And then I shot him because some weird, like, cancerous pus was coming out of him after I hit him with my stick. I did more damage than the gunshots with my stick, by the way.
Yeah.
Beating stick is always more effective than shitty Russian surplus ammo.
Exactly. So, weird stuff going on. We search his house. The wife is promiscuous, is to say the least. We don't find anything. Daughter's drawing creepy pictures because...
So we need to throw her in gulag for unbecoming activities of a party member.
Yes. Daughter is drawing creepy pictures, of course, of things that Mikhail had dreams of. And we see a house with the windows blacked out, so we go to investigate because that's not... permitted.
It's against party regulations.
Yes, because it's against party regulations. Guy claims to be a vampire. I notice that he's lying, so I kick him out the door, and he sits there writhing in pain. His wife cuts her wrist and, like, feeds it to him, and he runs inside. And I determined that his pain was fake. And, yeah, I think that's where we are right now, right? We're in the vampire guy's house.
The character synopsis really quick here.
I'm just using my character stat block. I only used, like, two of the things that are
character traits
for him.
All right. Okay. Well, I will just roleplay character as I see it. My character still looks like nerd, so it's okay.
So, yeah.
So it fits you.
He tried to play on our morality by having the wife and daughter of the guy that we killed crying, and I was like, he assaulted an officer.
He insulted a member of the party, and so he must be terminated accordingly.
Exactly. And then we killed him. No, we didn't kill the family.
All right. Should have killed the family. They were complicit in the assault of a party officer.
God, you're a ton of fun, aren't you?
Duh. I'm really fun.
To be fair, we haven't been the fun party at all, except for me tying a stick.
We are, in fact, fun police. We are here to make sure you're not having too much fun.
We stopped in a random town and did multiple spot hidden checks to determine whether or not they were doing acts that were against the state. I determined that nobody was smiling, so that's okay.
Is this that town that was from that shitty Nicolas Cage movie?
Yes.
Are you about to, like, put a headdress on someone and shove it full of bees? Yet? Okay.
There's a lot of bees. That's obviously Leviathan. Like, straight up, like, squiggly Leviathan.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Met up my lower third.
By the way, that was my shitty synopsis, so.
That was a pretty good one. All right, so Logan, I'm just going to kind of like slide you in and be like, yeah, you were here, because I think it's a lot of extra work in order to try and like shoehorn you in, like being here already somehow. So I don't be lazy. So what are we going to do? Yeah, they were going to go look at the body of the woman who had drowned, because that's one of the things that kind of got brought up to your attention while you guys got here. It is over in the Skolyaska house, their family, which is... What the fuck is it? Oh, it's number 9 on the map, if you have it there.
I do not have the map.
It should be in the group chat. Don't
have a map.
I will pull up the map.
There is no map in the group chat, just in the list of names.
I will post the map because I'm a good DM.
Scheiße.
When do we start crossing names off the list?
Guess you can cross Andre's name off the list, huh?
Yeah, because he attacked me. Which Andre, though? There's like three.
Andre Chikatilo.
Chikatilo.
Ha.
Ha, the zinger.
Bing bong. Which bing bong are you?
Bong bing?
The Chinese one. Fascinating.
So you guys right now are number 14. They're in 19.
Also, we have determined that the fields are shitty, so nobody in this town is working.
Well, you see, the more that they produce, the more that they will eventually get back when party distributes it evenly across all boundaries.
Okay. You guys got that?
I just rolled a random percentage die and rolled a 99, so.
Okay. So, you guys are heading over to the house number 9 there? Take a look. All right. So you guys approach this house. It looks exactly the same as every other house that you guys have seen.
Good.
And there's a door in front of you.
All right, let's approach the door as we have with all of them.
Open door for Stalin.
Colors.
Huh? Is it painted proper Soviet colors?
Is it painted in un-Soviet colors?
No, it's proper Soviet colors.
Good.
Okay, so you guys knock on the door, and a very thin man approaches the door. He says, "What do you want?"
We're here to examine body.
I am trying to do this. You should come back later, tomorrow.
We are representatives of the Communist Party. We are allowed to come whenever we feel like it. Please open your door for us, or we will have to prosecute you.
And he opens the door up, and he lets you guys in. And he steps back near the head of the body. I will make a spot hidden check.
What? 100, baby!
Good work.
I walk in with my hands covering my eyes.
My cat is pressing against the door.
I rolled
98. I'm too busy. Paying attention.
Logan and I are looking at each other.
Yeah, I'm like staring into the guy's eyes because he just tried my life.
Josh, Adam.
I'm too busy entranced by the Stalin statue.
Hero of Muppet. No for me, also.
Adam?
96, I said so.
Fuck.
Did we all roll 90 or higher?
To be fair, I think my glasses are a little foggy because we just went from the cold outside to the warm inside, so I need to, like...
Yeah, and you see a woman laying on the table in the middle of the home. Very thin, late 40s. And she's just in a simple dress.
She's lying on the middle of the table?
She's dead as shit.
Yeah.
And I begin taking off the dress.
You need to listen under skills here.
I would like to start searching the house for any objects against the state.
I would like to go and examine her body. Completely medically, of course.
Watch and cover them.
You're going to search the house?
Yes.
Can you make another spot hidden, please?
This time, 45 out of 50.
Okay. You're digging around and you're stepping around looking, and you step on like a board and it feels kind of loose. So you pry it up, and there's a secret compartment there. And there's two religious icons and a cross in there. Vasily goes, I don't know what that is. That must have been from whoever lived here before.
You guys want to believe him? Because I don't.
You should have destroyed such iconography when you found it originally.
Do I know about this cross?
Just a cross.
Clearly religious object.
Is Orthodox Christian cross.
Yeah.
It have the this and then the diagonal one down there.
That's not Orthodox.
That's Eastern Orthodox.
It's not.
The cross is not Orthodox, is what he's saying.
Oh, it's not. Oh, I'm sorry. I thought he was telling me that's not an Orthodox cross.
No, no, no.
I was about to be like, you're trying myself.
I'm sorry. I'm not trying to mess with the Soviet weeaboo over here.
Can I roll law to hear?
It's called Slavaboo, thank you.
This type Slavaboo. Of cross would be illegal.
Slavaboo.
It's religious iconography, which is against the state.
It is, but it's not really enough to have him denounced. Like, it's kind of one of those things where it's like
it's generally overlooked,
like a slap on the wrist, and then like That's about it.
I'll pull out my knife, hold it to his throat, and make him denounce.
What the fuck?
You don't read my backstory.
Yeah, he denounces and he screams.
Say that you would fuck the Virgin Mary. Say that you would fuck the Virgin Mary. That's what he's doing right now, basically.
I will remove the knife and give him a nice pet on the head.
Call her a dirty whore.
He says, I assume you're not here to talk about my religious preferences, but to talk about my wife.
I would like to be performing a medicine check on his wife.
Yes, make a medicine check.
Can I get below an 80? The answer to that is yes, 35.
Sweet. It reveals that she definitely did drown. However, there are no signs that she was held underwater. There's like no hemorrhaging in her eyes or around her neck. No idea that she struggled. And there's a very faint set of teeth marks on her neck that did not break the skin.
Found in her husband's cum. Is that what you're telling me?
No, it's the guy who thinks he's a vampire. He actually bit it. Or at least bit the body afterwards.
There appears to be no signs of foul play here. However, I do find these bite marks relatively suspicious. Sir, were you engaging in necrophilia with your dead wife?
Well, no.
I look back at the body and then look at him. I would like for you to bite down on that bite mark just to make sure that your teeth impressions do not match.
He refuses to do so.
Good, I'm just fucking
with you. Oh, you also find a revolver in one of the drawers.
This is illegal weaponry.
Is it?
No. I actually don't know. How far outside of, like, Moscow? Or
like, 8 hours
are
outside.
Are we in the boonies?
No, like 8 hours outside of,
yeah,
like, the nearest main city.
Is it loaded?
Yeah.
I'd like to pick it up and try to shoot it out.
Careful.
You're going to pick up the gun.
Guns go off on their own. Metagaming ways.
I need to test this. If it's just my gun.
Just make sure not to point it at anyone. Good weapon discipline.
Yeah, you pick up the gun and it doesn't shoot.
Use your trigger discipline.
Can you guys make a hard spot hidden check?
Sure thing, boss.
I'm not even gonna roll.
17 out of 50. I did it.
What's my spot hidden?
I did it.
I don't get the hard one, but I get 50 out of 50.
No, you get hard.
I did it. 17 out of 50 is enough.
5 out of 45. What are we looking for? You were just trying to see if you could see something. Jack, you see something like...
Another sanity. Let's go.
You see something small, like, sliding across the floor.
Oh, shit.
Towards Josh.
Is it a domovoy?
I want a spirit.
You go to spirit, and then realize that you're stabbing at a knife. And the knife jets out, and it's going to slash Josh in the back of the leg. Josh, take 3 damage. As this, like, just knife...
Now, you see, this is against...
Is this, like, this a floating
against,
knife?
This is against party policy.
It's literally a floating knife.
This is some sort of spring trap. I'm going to have to write you up a reprimand and then execute you immediately.
No,
I'm going to take the revolver and fire it down. Like,
shoot the knife
at the ground.
Yeah, you shoot around through the wood floor, and the knife is just kind of laying there. And you're bleeding from the back of your leg there.
I'd like to examine him for tetanus.
I don't think you can do that.
Can I stab the knife?
Yeah, Jack, you can stab the knife.
Essentially, is the knife rusty?
No.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry, my... Okay, I'm going to tell him, I'm sorry, my friend. It appears as though you've caught tetanus. I'm going to have to operate and remove your leg.
I will hold the revolver to the doctor's head.
That's going to go off.
I get shot with it.
So you are going to actively aim a gun at another member of
the... Are you pointing your weapon at the superior officer?
I just fired it.
Guns go off on their own here. You fool.
Yeah, are you guys going to... action and will going, be going on your permanent record.
You're gonna kill Logan. We need a doctor so this won't happen. I mean, I just fired the gun where I meant to.
It's a revolver, though. We have more than one round.
Well, I know, but I'm saying, like, I had full control of the gun. Just check it ago.
Yeah, but the floating knife is cause for concern. Are you going to react to him aiming a gun at another member of the NKVD?
Well, he's
trying to intervene.
Okay.
And before the gun goes off on its own.
Having my own gun go off on its own earlier, I will maybe try to like smack the gun out of your hand or something.
Yeah, I'll move it down after a couple seconds.
After a couple of seconds, all right.
A couple seconds is enough time for spook.
I just shot the gun at the ground. I have full control over it.
I'm not saying you didn't have full control those other times. I'm saying the gun went off.
I pointed at the ground and shot, right?
Yes.
Yeah, sure. So, as far as I'm concerned, I have control of this gun, right?
I mean, as far as you know, yeah. But as far as you know...
It's not like a fucking stallion that you have to break in.
Yeah, like, it's a gun. Like,
yeah, but in character he would know, but I don't know why in character he would aim the gun at you.
Well, he said he could have cut my leg off.
I was joking. Come on, don't you have a sense of humor?
You laughing, Gulag.
Yeah.
We all saw the floating knife, right?
Yeah, I mean, crazy crap going around. I think my character is allowed to act a little paranoid right now.
But did he see the floating knife?
Yeah, make a sanity check for yourself there now.
Me?
To be fair, none of us were observant enough to see the knife initially.
I passed it again.
Yeah. Okay. You are starting to freak out though because like this stuff's just like happening. You know?
I do not know what you're talking about. I'm a man of science. Everything has a proper explanation. Believing in fairy tales is unbecoming of a party officer.
Unless you're a Nazi and you believe in the occult.
If they are Nazi, then we put them down like fascist dogs.
The Nazis aren't a... They are a thing.
Now they are.
Now they are.
When does this take place?
And they're using magic.
Oh, no.
What year does this take place in?
Actually, yeah, I don't know what year this is.
37.
Oh, so yeah, they're sort of a political party right now.
Like Trump is right now. So yeah, where are you guys going to head next? At this point, you guys have been wandering around all day. You've shot a couple people, shot some guns, and it's now...
stab your knife.
It's now nearing, like, 6 p.m.
I would like to... Okay, so who is in charge?
Galron.
Who's our commanding officer?
Oh, your commanding officer? About 8 hours away. You do have a radio in the truck, though.
Like right here. I mean, right here? Who's in charge here?
I don't know.
Who's the highest ranked officer here?
Talk amongst thyselves. Oh, wait. Okay, who are we playing?
Let's see.
You're a doctor.
I'm playing Timur Alexandrovich Yarov, NKVD agent / doctor.
I'm an engineer.
I have a big, bushy mustache.
Who has the biggest Stalinist mustache?
I don't have
I'm pretty sure it's me, because I literally have a Stalin mustache, but it's blonde.
I'm going to say that Logan is in charge then. Purely for his bushy mustache.
Mustache?
Da. Your father's a prominent doctor.
Under the Tsar.
And you own an apartment, so yeah.
Okay. You're the richest man. I'm a ranking member in MK. So,
actually, you know what determines this better? What's everyone's credit rating?
My credit rating?
40. Yeah,
credit rating is 56.
Minus 55, just slightly less.
65.
Yeah, so we're going in order of credit rating here. That's based, because credit rating in a socialist government doesn't really matter. It kind of determines your placement instead. So yeah.
All right. So I would like to go to our commanding officer and say, "It's getting rather late. Would you like to come and get us a place to sleep? Investigate further into the night."
I will not stay at that horrible house again. Let us stay at the village master. Have him sleep with the cows.
Perhaps we could leave him outside to snuggle with his dead wife, huh?
So, we're in this house, right? Wait, I just got stabbed in this house, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
Golly, so I had to choose.
Did you just come into another house?
The house as a vampire. The house that just stabbed me.
The house where we killed the guy that lived in it.
Do you think the vampire is, like, the most trustworthy person we know?
Well, he did try and turn himself in, so...
That will be entirely fair. Such a psychological disorder is probably going to have most of his cards on the table, considering his deep, dark manifestations are... You know, he's wearing them on his sleeve, so to speak.
So, let's stay with the vampire.
I never thought I would hear someone say that with my own ears, but... I suppose there are weirder things that we could possibly be snuggled with.
Would that guy be afraid of me?
Probably.
Jesus.
Sunlight? Are we dying?
You put him
in the vampire, you said?
Yep.
Okay, one more check. Okay.
I'd like to scratch my very prominent cheekbones.
Logan, quit being a gay.
Bruh, did you see the little portrait art for him? He's got like the sharpest fucking cheekbones I've ever seen.
He's probably gay.
They look like right angles.
Yeah, so where are you guys going to stay? You're staying with Vampire?
Yeah.
We are commandeering House of Vampire Man so that we can sleep the night away without freezing to death.
All right. So you guys go into this house. So you guys doing watch and that kind of stuff?
Yeah, probably same order as last night, unless the commanding officer wants to sleep the whole night, then we'll just do a rotation of three.
I don't really like sleep anymore.
Okay. So everybody gets a rotation of 1 hour and then 3 hours of sleep and then 1 hour awake. Like we do in the militaries. It also equally distributes the sleep, so, you know.
Yeah, because it sucks to stay up for 2 hours and sleep for six. Yeah, okay. So who's gonna? Let's make luck rolls. Everyone make a luck roll.
I failed. I have 25 luck.
I barely passed with a 43 out of 45.
My luck is 50, so I mean, I might as well flip a coin. But hey,
I got a 46 out of 50.
I got a 28 out of 50.
Solid. All right. Josh, I don't feel like I'm picking on you, but your luck rolls. Oh, shit.
Are you getting attacked by NKVD officers? Are they banging on your door?
I have like, see the French doors there? my mom walked up and she knocked on it and scared me.
Oh.
The mother is the most terrifying of all Eldritch Horrors.
Yeah.
I mean, you're not wrong.
Mom, go away!
She'll make a lot of bugs.
What?
Only if I have enough good boy points to get my chicken tendies.
God, I wish they would.
She goes, some chalky milk.
Sounded she like goes, he was responding to the chicken tendies. Just, God, I wish they would.
No, she goes, you should have locked the door because the rapist could have been and gotten you. And that's what my response was to. I'm lonely.
Logan was saying that you were wondering if you had enough good boy points for chicken tendies, and then you said, God, I wish they would.
The good news if the rapist did come, you catch it on tape, so you could play it back for analysis later.
No, because then people just get stuck and unfriended.
Guys, don't hang up, or a bad movie will happen.
I'm on butt crocs.
Okay, I'm hanging up right now just so that I can have a chance at dying.
No. She's showing me
the
new Crocs she right now.
So rude to your mother.
She's showing me the new Crocs she bought.
The new what?
The new Crocs.
Oh, Crocs. I thought you said the new
Crocs. She told me from the window, like, really look, I got new Crocs. Okay, I'm sorry. I'm really off topic here.
we're sleeping with the vampire. I failed the luck roll. Something horrible is about to happen to me. I'm about to have another bad dream.
It's yeah, okay. So
I'll succeed in my luck roll and only gain... and only lose one luck point.
Your bad dreams are only latent manifestations of your psychological damage.
No, actually, your hour that you spend on watch, your first hour goes by fine. And you sleep, and then the second hour, and then right before your second hour, you have a dream, right? I just had a dream somewhere. Stop.
Logan, be careful. You're being devoured by some sort of creature.
Yeah. I don't care.
It's okay. I am bundled up like it is nice Siberian winter.
Hold on, guys.
I have a battery. I look like a cult member.
Could I attribute this extra attention to his mother to Freudian psychology?
I'm sorry, what?
Could I apply this, all the attention that Michael has to his mother to Freudian psychology?
Okay, I'm sorry.
Probably.
What's the exchange rate for good boy points in rubles? Adam, why is your camera off? I want to see my sweet little Adam.
I had to plug something in behind my computer because...
It's like 10 rubles to a good boy point, by the way.
Oh, sweet. I have two good boy points. Two Soviet youth points.
I have 9 Hitler Jugend points. What's your point?
Logan, have you been watching or have you been listening to Wizard and the Bruiser?
Maybe.
Dude, I love that podcast.
Wizard, ready for the winter.
Wizard and the Bruiser, I'm kind of thinking of rerolling up as a sorcerer, though. That was my favorite quote, mine. So, I'm sorry, we're getting really off topic here. We need to get back into it.
Everything's on top.
So, you wake up, and you wander outside again. And you walk out the door, and you find yourself all of a sudden, like, in this alien landscape. You don't know where you are.
Oh shit, we're going full Dyatlov Pass here.
It's just Dyatlov, right?
Wait, all of us are just Josh?
It's Dyatlov, and they mispronounced it for the entire episode, and it pissed me off.
Logan, quit being a fucking weeb. You
look,
walk outside.
Man, all right?
Logan. God damn it. You walk outside, and it's like a completely alien, barren landscape. It's flat. It's like... purpley, it's weird. You don't understand. When you turn around and the house is gone, they just walked out of. Make a sanity roll, please.
All of us are just
remember your coat, or did you strip down into your underwear?
Okay,
I'm currently wearing.
Did you strip down into your underwear and are trying to climb a tree?
Okay. Oh, I don't have any sanity points.
Guys,
it's extreme.
Oh, sweet. You managed to keep your cool, but you still take two sanity points. 2 points of sanity damage. Like, you're terrified of where you are. And you pretty much you just blink, and all of a sudden you're like standing like between some houses. You don't know like what happened. You're confused, but you do see Maria, the wife of
Shadow the Hedgehog,
the wife of the guy you killed, walking out. It's obviously pretty late, and she shouldn't be out.
We did not murder anyone. It was a sanctioned execution by party members.
It's true.
I will ask her what she's doing out so late.
She's around to the corner and like kind of walked. Like you saw her walk past.
You sneaky.
I would probably run around the corner.
Yeah. You run around the corner. Make a spot hidden roll for me.
I'm horrible at spot hidden.
Who the fuck is like loading a gun into their microphone? Like, what is that noise?
I was unwrapping a candy bar. It's an equally American
fucking
thing, right?
Glorious. Okay, but that is it imported chocolate? Because if so, that is contraband and it is liable for
really hot.
Okay, you guys, back to the game though. Josh?
No joke, it's really hot in here.
Josh?
I failed.
You fucking idiot.
You failed? You know what's funny though? You kind of wanted to fail. You see Maria like tuck something in the back of her jacket. And she says, oh, hey, what are you doing out so late?
It is my job.
It's spaghetti falling out of her pants.
It's my job to keep watch, I'll tell her.
Well, if you're not too busy, and she kind of like approaches you.
She gonna suck that dick?
Hey guys, if we're not being talked to, can we mute?
And I'll let her know that I cannot break my watch.
She runs up and she like runs her like arm like up yours, like her hand up your arm.
I will take her arm and twist it behind her back.
That's not how you flirt.
Into that kinky
that might not be how you flirt.
She's so into it. Look at her.
Give me 1 second.
How well can you understand me? Or is it like Kenny?
We are number one. Hey.
There's no response when you can't.
So you just gonna twist her arm behind her back?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And she says, what? Are you afraid to be intimate?
I will throw her to the ground and say, not even your husband was intimate with you.
This is getting like, really.
Are you afraid of this machine? I don't know if you meant to misspell that, but that made it even funnier.
I did. I didn't mean to misspell it.
Goober. Wait, no, she had sex with her husband a lot. No, she's like, no, he never wanted any. But maybe you do, and she's gonna like kind of like push at you again.
Okay. I do not blame him. I just kind of like throw to the ground then. Walk away.
Make a listen check.
It's gonna be like a baby. If you pass, does he hear you unwrapping your candy?
I could have failed in her bet.
Is that a crit? Does he hear the Eldritch gods unwrapping their candy bars?
I passed.
A 57?
No, you hear them rolling their d20s.
Yep. I have 65.
Oh, damn. You hear like a fleshy, like... That was really bad.
Wait, what was that? I made
you hear like a fleshy, like, sound.
From where?
Behind you.
I'll turn around.
On Maria's back, you see a huge tentacle. Check it out. Please make another sanity roll.
Boom, another crit. Well, not crit, extreme.
Take 4 points of sanity damage.
All right.
How much are you at total?
I've went below 10%. I mean, I've lost 10%.
It's one fifth.
One fifth. All right, good. Yeah, so I've lost. I'm at point of penetration.
You see this tentacle like extending out of her back. Let's roll to see what kind of sanity you're dealing with here. I kind of like this idea of you go insane because you've been like the one seeing all these things.
Yep.
And like slowly like realizing that something horrible is happening. So this should be fun. Can you give me? Oh, hold on. I have it right here. I think I'm gonna tailor something insane towards you, so like something kind of like fun for you. You know what I mean? Excuse me.
Give me a phobia.
I'm trying to flip the sanity page. But I don't remember where it is.
/183?
Yep, I just got to it.
Is it really 183?
No, it's 157.
But yeah, I play way too much Call of Cthulhu if I do that. I think 183 might be the phobia.
You've been pretty trigger happy these last few days, this last day or two. So you'll draw the revolver. You have the revolver on you that you took from what's his name?
I probably would have carried it because you don't trust my gun anymore.
Yeah, so you draw a gun and you pick it up, you hold it up to Maria, and you fire a few shots into her, and she falls over like dead. The rest of you guys, can you guys make listen checks real quick?
Listen, you said?
I failed.
Make it hard, actually. Make it hard, listen, Jeff.
Ah, shit. My listen's already a 20. This is going to be bad.
Make it hard.
90 out of 20. I see I spent all of my good rolls on Shesla.
We're all deaf.
I rolled a 54 out of 20.
Yeah,
I sleep the sleep of a guiltless Soviet secret police officer.
So basically, you shoot her dead. No one else wakes up. You're a little too far away. And you walk over to her. You flip her over. And you have a knife on you, right?
Yep.
And you're going to cut her... Jesus, guys. You're going to cut the back of her shirt off. And, yeah, actually. You're going to go for that tentacle. Like, this thing, like, it kind of shriveled back down. But, like, it, like, sticks out of her spine. And you're going to go and you're just going to, like, saw it off. And it's kind of, like, wriggling around. And it crawls up your arm and down the back of your shirt. And then you come back to like where you were and you remember nothing of what happened.
Okay.
Except that you have now killed this woman and skinned her. Well, you walk back to the house you're staying at, and you stand back to guard like nothing happened. Oh, you go back to bed. Oh, who's on guard? Shit.
I mean, he was on guard when he left.
He wasn't. He was sleeping.
Oh, shit. Well, let's roll a d3. Jack, you're 1. Adam's 2. I'm 3. Reroll on 4.
Or you can roll d6 and cut in half.
Well, I already rolled a 2, so.
So it's you?
That's Adam.
No, Adam. Okay. So yeah, you walk back and Adam is standing on guard.
Hey, I did not see you leave. What are you doing? Have you been having nightmares again? Are you holding the tentacle like in your hand?
Were you having wet dreams again? Perhaps it is latent manifestation of your psychology.
So none of you guys know this, but like
I blame Japan.
It's basically it's crawled under a spine and it kinda like it like envelops over it. And he doesn't know that he can like you don't know that you can like almost control it yet. But like it almost exerts a force over you.
It's an emerald tentacle.
It's a hentai tentacle. But like it kinda like it like lays over your spine. And no one else can really see it, but it like extends and stretches out as you
okay.
So up to 4 feet. Spine.
As you get erect.
Yeah. So but you really can't see it. You have to take off his shirt and like inspect the area.
Well, that's gonna happen one way or another, because you know
how the secret police like party.
What are you doing out of bed? You should be sleeping. At this point, it's not your watch turn.
At this point, your temporary insanity is gone.
I would probably just kind of walk past him.
I would try and stop you so you answer my questions.
You remember waking up from the nightmare, but that's it.
Like, sir, clearly you're not well.
Okay. I had to check the car again. Make sure that no one else was stealing more parts.
I rolled a 25 over 10 for psychology, so I guess I believe him.
Yeah.
I think I'm going to pass fast talk.
That's odd, but I believe you because we're such good close buddies. So close that maybe we take shirts off.
But never lie to each other. However, I would still like to rub your bosom.
I was like, well, go back to sleep. She'll be your watch soon also.
You slap his butt as he goes in. Good kid.
Hold on, let me see.
Of course.
Do I smack his butt?
He's only game. Why do you have to be bad?
Yeah.
Okay. And I would pass my watch on to whoever's next unless something weird happens.
Who's next?
If we're going in numerical order, Jack was first in with him, then it should be me.
Okay. Logan, nothing really happens during the night. As you're kind of standing around the house, like, where are you standing?
It depends. Where are we sleeping?
In a bed.
But is that a separate room, or is it just like...
No, it's like in the main room. There's a few little windows, and then there's a door.
Would like to position myself to where I have the most visibility of the various entrances to the house. So like windows, doors, etc.
Okay. The door, while you're on your watch, the door like creaks open, right? And as you kind of like go to like look at it, it slams shut.
There's a hell of a draft they have here. Someone should check that out.
But other than that, nothing else really, nothing really important other than that happens.
I sort of like prop a chair in front of the door, just in case.
It must have just been my imagination.
Yeah. Other than that, nothing else really happens. Yeah. Okay, so you guys wake up the next morning. You still have another day until the train arrives. Well, you guys still have to figure out what you're going to do to help fix it here, too. You guys haven't really come up with a solution yet. So, like, overall, you guys need to come up with...
Who needs that?
Well, you guys do need to either, like... You were sent here to arrest the Abramoff family. But I think you guys have discovered there are also some bigger fish to fry along with that.
I would mention to Logan and Jack's characters that something weird was going on with Josh last night. He was out of bed during my watch. And if I could, I would try and pull them aside to where I knew Josh wouldn't be able to hear. And I would let them in on my suspicions.
The first night where something very similar happened, and like he woke up in the middle of the night, sleepwalking up to a wall, and then seemed quite startled.
Can I roll psychology to analyze this, or do I roll psychoanalysis to analyze this?
Psychoanalysis.
Okay. 26 out of 45?
And then...
40. Yeah, 26 out of 40.
What other rolls are there? What other types of rolls are there?
What do you mean?
Like skills.
What are you rolling for? What are you trying to do?
He's rolling a psychoanalysis check.
It would be psychology, not psychoanalysis.
Oh, well then 26 out of
65. What would you roll to like combat it?
For me to combat psychoanalysis?
Yeah.
I mean...
Whatever bluff.
I mean, I don't think I'm trying to hide anything. I'm not aware.
Oh, so you're not aware, are you? Yeah, so you can tell like he is definitely just not aware of what's going on. Josh is one of those parasites from Rick and Morty. we were great friends. Remember the time we were stuck in the elevator after the Hulk musical?
I would like to lean into Adam's character. I would like to whisper into his ear, we may want to restrain him. He may cause severe harm to himself or...
Well, he clearly doesn't understand like what's happening.
Exactly, which means he can't be trusted with firearms.
I agree, our fellow comrade is confused and must be subdued.
Perhaps it would be good for me to examine him medically. Perhaps there is some sort of physical ailment that is causing this weird reaction.
Could I roll anything to see if I'm a doctor, after all? The three of them kind of meeting.
You don't have to roll anything. Bitter cookie.
So they're having this conversation like 10 feet away from me.
Yeah, like
we're whispering.
Can I roll listen to see if I can hear enough what they're saying?
Would make sense.
Can you make a whisper check?
So we roll stealth then?
No.
That's just success.
Okay, yeah. You can tell they're like talking about you, but you can't really pick out too much what they're saying.
I'll push it and listen harder.
Yeah, if you succeed in a roll, you can't push.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
Listen harder.
You're like... Yeah, you can tell they're talking about
something's
you.
Something's definitely going on. He's doing
some very weird stuff. Like this.
Yeah, he flies out of his back.
I will walk over to them, and I will say, why are you speaking about me? You're not arranging some type of coup.
Of course not. We
laugh.
That would be a crime against the Soviet Union, against the party. No, what we are trying to do is we're trying to figure out what exactly is causing you to be so, how you say, in this neck of the woods, acting so strangely. Your night terrors and other such things. I am, after all, a doctor of both the mind and the body.
I do not know what you are talking about.
I would like for you to remove your clothing for me, please. I need to make sure you have not been bitten by some sort of small animal or some other such thing that could be giving you some sort of rabies or some other kind of viral infection.
We don't know that there is some sort of weird virus going around this entire town. So
we're in the countryside. There's bound to be rats here somewhere.
Whatever was causing you to go crazy.
That was just so out of nowhere. I'd like you to remove your clothes.
Yeah. Now take off your shirt.
He puts on gloves.
It is cold, and you might be delusional. There was a nice woman we met.
We're inside the house. Everything will be fine. I will put up a privacy screen.
No,
you've already signed all the paperwork.
No, there was a nice widow we met who
it's okay.
Who offered such a service that might help you.
I'm just going to start unbuttoning his shirt now.
I'm going to grab my revolver, or the revolver I stole.
I would not recommend that you do that. You see, I have protective gloves here. It is to make sure that I am not going to be injured by any sort of parasite or some kind of disgusting animal bite that you may have.
The gloves defend from bullets.
I don't think taking a gun out to someone who might be raping you is that.
I'm not raping you. I'm just examining you to make sure that there is no sort of animal bite. I'm just trying to make sure that you don't have rabies. I'm trying. It is in your best interest, really.
I'm also like prepared to defend the doctor. So just like if, I don't know how setting reactions works, but I'm ready to like subdue. Even though I'm not a big guy, my brawl is pretty low.
Yeah, could I roll a fighting brawl to kind of do a battle maneuver to push the doctor away from me as he begins to undress me?
Dodge! Yeah, I was just saying, are you gonna push him? Jesus, you guys are all going crazy with each other.
I'm not going crazy. I'm just trying to examine him and make sure he hasn't been bitten by some sort of rabid animal.
Guys, did you know that wool hats are really warm?
Logan, can you make a persuade roll for it?
Persuade? Sure. Do I have anything in persuade? I don't think I do. No, I do. I have 45%.
Ooh, I have a super high persuade. Could I persuade him?
45 out of 45.
So, I mean, like, it's kind of up to you. Hold on. It's up to you, Josh, he seems genuinely sincere, like he just wants to make sure you're okay.
I'm here for the betterment of all of your health. See, we're in the middle of nowhere, which is why I'm here. Make sure that you do not catch an infection and bring it back.
I am definitely against this, but since I see morale is low, I am willing to...
to strip down for them?
I am willing to put up with this charade in order to appease my mission.
Just think about it. You got your leg stabbed by some weird random knife. For all we know, that could have been infected with some sort of disgusting virus.
It's not safe to be with three insane teammates, so I'm willing to appease them so that they might come back to Shandy.
So I take off his clothes.
I will take off my own clothes. I will take off my own clothes.
Okay. That is the least I can let you have.
Yeah, so can I isolate that? So I take off his clothes.
I'm trying.
I can take off my own clothes.
In my defense, it is cold in the room.
Yes,
sir, it's cold. no, but so Logan, make a medicine check.
Sure thing. I'm just giving him a routine physical here.
Yeah, so I'm just standing there with my hammer and chickle, just hanging in the breeze.
It's cold, guys.
So that's a 60 out of 80.
Yeah, so you're kind of looking him over very sensually. And you notice that there's
going to need to turn your head and cough.
You don't notice there's a tentacle on. Like there's not a tentacle, okay. There's like a weird lump on his spine.
I'd like to poke it.
It's soft.
Does it feel like firm?
It's soft and squishy.
Okay.
Well, after he poked you.
Excuse me.
Well, as you poke it, Logan, it it like extends out. Everyone make a sanity check, except Josh, because you're not looking at it.
31 out of 70.
73 out of 75. I'm putting away these dice. These have not been fun for me.
And then Adam?
I got an 81 out of 80.
You take 2 points of sanity damage.
How do I know how many I have total?
Well, yeah, you subtract from your sanity score.
Okay.
So if you lose 5 in one go, you get a temporary insanity, which I determined. And if you lose a fifth of your sanity points in one game session, then you get a temporary insanity. Which in his case was the extreme violence where he gunned down a woman and then stole her tentacle.
And took her, stole her tentacle.
You're both old.
What about the rest of us? What about the rest of us?
You guys like just look at this and you're like, holy shit.
I suppose that this is not the weirdest thing that they've ever seen. I mean,
I've seen bigger in Siberia.
Guys, it's joint wings, residual limbs.
You see this this tentacle like just like coming out of the out of your comrade's back, and you're like, you're taken back. You don't understand it.
Do you understand?
Spaghetti falls out of my pants.
Mama spaghetti.
Of course, only the best.
So yeah, that's what goes on,
comrade. Have you always had this growth on your spine?
Am I aware of the?
Once they all like freak out, and then he asks you about the tentacle, you're like, Logan has a mirror in his doctor's bag. You're gonna show him Logan?
Mirror.
Yeah.
I hand him the mirror, and be sure to angle it. Not
we needed a mirror earlier!
Well, Logan wasn't here earlier.
I know, but Logan solves all of the problems we had earlier.
They couldn't find a mirror to prove the guy wasn't a vampire.
You have just used the car mirror?
Well, but we could be right outside.
That would have been destruction of state property.
No, there's a
Josh, it's kind of up to you how you react to
it. You'd have to remove it.
You're just taking him into the
car. If I'm aware that he's coming on my back, I think I'm just going to fail that sanity.
I mean, it's your choice if you've, like, I think it's your choice if you want to be like, holy shit, I didn't know this was here, or, like, you see it and you're like, you kind of like a flashback, like, no, I did this to myself, and you're not freaked out about it.
I think I'm freaked out about it.
Okay, yeah, so make a sanity roll then.
Whoa! Like,
I can pass.
Yeah, so you see it, and you're like, holy shit, holy shit. But part of you almost feels like you knew it was there, you know? Like, you're like, it's like, it's kind of like when you, like, you ever hurt yourself, and you know you've hurt yourself, and you look at it, and you're like, ah, that's as bad as I thought it'd be. Yes. It's kind of like that.
Yes, I smile knowing that I will make a good super soldier for Stalin.
Do you say that out loud?
No, you won't, because you're not half gorilla.
I slept with a typical.
I mean, you look it, but me. Like.
So yeah, it's up to you guys. What's going to happen now?
Do I have control over this tentacle?
If you choose to embrace it.
Does he feel anything that touches the tentacle?
Yeah, you. Maria usually gave it. Holy shit, guys!
Is this a parasite or a symbiote?
It depends on how you react to it.
Fell out of his pants.
No, I got really excited because I forgot I had to thank you, and now I want to play it, but I have a Mac, so I can't play it.
Fucking scrub.
Fucking Mac.
I have a thing.
I'll give Mac? It.
Look at that little cup.
I'll give control. Like, me.
Tangent. You know what we could do? I can share my screen. We can all play Drawful. After this, though.
Well, first of all, I would like for someone to restrain his arms so I can test how responsive this tentacle is to outside. I'm going to test to see if the tentacle has a lot of reflexes.
Logan, you're going to make it jerk you off, aren't you?
I make no promises.
No.
I'm going to comply and try to hold him down.
I need to test its reflexes to make sure that it is a physical part of your body and not something attaching itself to its mind.
I'm going to say you don't have to pin him down to do that.
Yeah, I'm not going to.
Want to pin him down.
He's got I'm not going to hurt you. I'm just going
to
strangle
you. He's got a fucking tentacle coming out of his back. I want him restrained.
God, that's such a good movie. I'm not going to hurt you. Well, I'm just going to bash your skull in.
He could willingly be restrained if that's any solace.
I'll leave it to you guys. You guys fight it out. This is between you guys.
Comrade, I'm going to ask our compatriots here to restrain you just in case your reflexes are a bit too much. While I test to make sure that this tentacle is a functioning part of your nervous system and not something just extra.
You do not restrain a superior officer.
I need to make sure that you're not going to punch me for what I'm about to do.
I will not punch you, and I'll put my hands on the whatever is in front of me, the table in front of me, and brace myself.
Okay. You go down your elbows like getting your prostate examined.
I would like to pick up the revolver, fire it into the ground, and press the hot barrel against the tentacle.
The moment I hear the gun go off, I think I would turn around. Unless you warn me what you're doing.
I'm going to make sure it's responsive to heat.
You have a lighter, Logan.
Yeah, but this is way more fun. This is way more fun.
Oh, it's like the stick knife on fire.
Logan, make a luck roll for me.
Ultimate weapon.
Okay. Where's my luck?
Oh yeah, 50? Back.
Okay, 50-50 shot.
Back to the gun.
43 out of 50.
Yeah, the gun is unloaded. The other bullets are gone.
Well, that's weird.
What about
I'll put the revolver down. I'll put the revolver down, and I'll pick up my Tokarev TT-30 auto pistol, fire it into the ground, and press the hot barrel against the tentacle.
Yeah, you do that, and the gun just goes off again. It shoots through the tentacle. The tentacle's gonna like shrivel up back into his spine.
Yeah, well, that was uncalled for.
Do I feel anything?
Make a luck roll.
Yeah, I'm basically trying to see if it's connected to your central nervous system.
I failed.
How much did you fail by?
46 or 25.
Okay. Why are you such low luck? Holy cow.
He's not that lucky, man.
I've done some bad things.
Jack, what are you doing?
He's masturbating.
What do you think? You've chosen to embrace it. I'm going to say you feel like a sharp pain go throughout your body. It doesn't hurt you.
That hurt.
It hurts you, but it doesn't like physically hurt you, if you know what I'm saying.
But
did you feel pain?
Do I feel like he tried to shoot me?
No, it just like it stings, you know. It's like he like pinched you, but
all right. Oh, that's pretty. All right. So I don't have any reason to believe that he might be trying.
On a scale of 1 to 10, can you rate your pain? 1 being little to no pain at all. 10 being oh my god, you just shot me in my fucking arm.
Roll a d10.
Three.
Yep.
So like a, oh my god, you shot me in my tentacle.
Like a, ow, why did you pinch me?
Okay. So from what I can understand, if this tentacle is a functioning part of your nervous system, if anything, it has a very decreased sensitivity to pain and whatnot. Maybe it is that does not have a lot of nerve endings in there. Perhaps it is a very thick, fleshy out exterior that doesn't have a lot of nerve endings. Either that, or it is some sort of parasitic organism that is trying to make sure that you're not injured. However, I do not see a demanding problem with it. So if you could do me a favor and put your shirt back on and then never show me that again, that would be wonderful.
Yeah, I'm sorry, doctor. Could you repeat that? I missed it.
Put your clothes back on.
And even though I've rushed and enjoy the buff in the snow, I will put my clothing back on.
Yeah, so at this point, you can hear a sizable crowd. You can notice like a sizable crowd starting to gather about halfway through the village.
I brandish the stick knife.
Are you guys gonna head over and see what's going on there?
Sure, why not?
I mean, yeah, okay. We have to. You said there's a commotion happening.
A commotion, eh? You see the body of Maria, the town whore, dead in the snow with...
Look, it is the body of Maria, the town whore, dead in the snow.
And there is... she's been, like, cut up and, like, part of her back is missing.
Observe as she has been cut up and part of her back is missing.
Kind of like...
I'd like to go up and examine the body.
Yeah, she's been shot 6 times.
Cause of death appears to be 6 gunshot wounds.
And then her back, her shirt was cut open, and she was, like, cut all through her back. Right about where you saw the, we're looking at a medicine check?
Medicine check, 22 out of 80.
Yeah, you realize that where it was cut is the exact location that, what's it called?
The same location where the tentacle is on my comrade,
yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. And your comrade, realizing the horrible thing that he has done, drops to his knees, realizing that he murdered this woman and tore her apart.
I don't think... I've done worse stuff than that.
I've only butchered a whore? That's not...
Like, I've done worse stuff than that.
Only butchering a whore.
I was trying to write you out here. I was just going to write you out here if you wanted.
Yeah.
Josh has to leave, so I was just going to write you out real quick.
And then the eldritch gods went and poked him with their finger and he evaporated.
Yes.
Everybody lose 100 sanity.
Whores are not real people.
It's okay. You just killed a hooker.
It's only a whore. It's fine.
I'm going to stop the broadcast because in a little bit. So yeah. You fall to the ground, realizing like, what you've done, and you just start like sobbing. And you put a gun up to your head, and you just shoot yourself. It's gonna be a quick write out, just because you do need to go.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah. Thanks, Josh, for coming by. I appreciate it.
All right.
Thank you, BB.
It was nice meeting you. Oh, he's gone.